Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and today is an exciting day because I'm going to show you how to use the brand new High Level Sidebar and where all your old stuff went as well. So let's get started.
So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out.
All right, so let's talk about the new high-level sidebar, everybody. So there are some features that you are not going to have access to if you don't turn on the new sidebar, like the search bar where you can search for contacts, opportunity cards, and add new ones, and also like the payments, all of the products in the payments tab, you're not going to have access to those either. And there's a lot of new features that you're missing out on. So what you can do, there are a couple options here. One is if you want to play with it before you give it to your clients, go up to your agency settings and then go down to the bottom of the page and you're in agency settings here. So go ahead and click on here, and this is going to tell you what your options are now. So you have three options. Okay, one is optional. So you're going to give your users the choice between the new sidebar, or they can switch to the old sidebar, okay? The choice is going to be below the profile avatar. Number two, mandatory new sidebar upgrade. So it's going to upgrade for every single user. And then mandatory old sidebar downgrade is going to force everyone to use the old sidebar again. So it is up to you which one that you want to choose, okay? I'm just going to go ahead and leave that there for now and show you how to change it. So I'm in a location, and I'm going to go ahead and click up here, and this is my profile avatar, but for some reason it's blank. So I'm going to click switch to new sidebar. All right, so looks totally different now. You're going to notice a lot of things moved and a lot of things changed. The first main difference you're going to notice is that your drop down for your accounts has been moved from here to here. Okay, so now you can click here and you can search for your accounts on the side. That's like the main thing that you're going to be confused about, okay? And then you're still having the dashboard, the conversations are still here, and now we have calendars here. Okay, this calendars tab used to be appointments, and now it's just called calendars. Okay, so that's where your appointments have moved to. And you have a contacts here. It used to be farther down on the menu bar. Opportunities are still here. So the orders kind of moved around a little bit, but it's not a big deal. This is one of the big changes here, payments. So payments is actually going to allow you to create and remove and search for products in all of your funnels. So let me show you what that looks like on an account that I actually have products in. All right, so you can kind of see once you're using High Level for a while, your products kind of get out of control, and especially if you do digital products. So now what you can actually do is you can search here. Okay, so you can do a full partial search, which is really cool. You can also import products from Stripe and create new products. And here you can look at orders, you can look at all the transactions, and you can manage your integration. So this is brand new and it's actually super helpful. This email marketing tab used to be underneath marketing and it was called the HTML builder. So now it's under email marketing. And you can go in here and modify all of your fancy email templates like this. So it has its own tab instead of being nested underneath marketing. Next, we have automation. And in automation, you will see workflows, campaigns, and triggers. Workflows, campaigns, and triggers all used to have their own tab. Workflows was above marketing. Then you had the campaigns underneath the marketing tab, and you had to, they were nested, and then you had triggers on its own. So now everything has been combined into one automation tab. And Sean actually said this was going to be easier to use, and I actually agree with him on that. I do think that I prefer it this way. I was resisting change for a long time, but this is actually pretty awesome. Okay, now Sites is going to house all of your funnels, websites, memberships, forms, surveys, chat widgets, and media and URL redirects, which is a ton, okay? But instead of each of these having their own tabs and being mixed and matched around the menu bar, they all now have their own drop-down menu here, which is really cool. And it's a lot easier to find. So Sites is going to have all of your website kind of related things, okay? Reputation, still reputation management. Not a lot's different here. And then again, reporting. This hasn't changed much as well. So you're gonna have all your call reporting and things here. And I'm gonna go into back into my, ooh, I like that. Did you see that little recent? That's nice. I like that. So reporting, you have call reporting and appointment reporting. Okay, so that's how the new menu bar works now. And that's where you're gonna find everything. Maybe you were a little bit lost before, but I actually think this is a lot easier. And then your settings are all the way down at the bottom now. And you're gonna get access to a few new settings because you move stuff around. One of those is going to be this company billing. There's a new thing now where if your client actually goes beyond what the balance is in their wallet, it's going to shut down all the communications that your client is making. So if they're past due, they can't continue to rack up a bill, which is really cool. Another new thing is this quick action. So now you can just click on quick action and it is going to let you add a contact, create an appointment, send a review request, or create an opportunity. So that one button that you had before is now essentially four buttons that you can decide what to do next. And my most favorite new feature that you're gonna notice now, I just did a quick refresh because this is literally a brand new feature, is the universal search bar. Wow, so look at this. I can look for Testy McTesterton, and there he is. There is Testy McTesterton. But not only that, I can search for opportunities, and I can look for payments. So let's say that someone bought something and they're asking like, hey, where's my thing? Well, you just go in here and you can check the contact, the opportunity, and the payments in one place. The other cool thing that you can do, let's say that you did a search for Sean and there is no one named Sean. So you can actually add an opportunity or a contact in here. And it will pop this up. Right here. Cool. How cool is that? You cannot do that on the old sidebar. So anyway, that's how you do the locations. And then at the company level, again, there is a brand new sidebar. But this is a lot more similar to the old menu. It's just that it looks a little bit different. So you're still going to find your profile, your company settings, your team settings, your billing settings, the snapshots. Everything is on the left side instead of on the top now, okay? The Mailgun, Twilio, SMTP, affiliate link, custom menu links, Stripe, API keys, compliance, launchpad, and audit settings. This is kind of a cool thing. You can actually disable the launchpad for your locations if you want to. And then the audit logs is new as well. So you can actually go in here and you can look up all of the changes that have been made by the users. So I hope this helps you guys to use the brand new high-level menu. Let me know in the comments what your favorite part about this new menu is. And don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me. Get your free trial in the description below. And I'll see you next time.